With the release of Mayhem 10 and all of the new weapons, Borderlands 3 feels kind of out of balance. Now, I could talk about multiple things to make this point to you guys, but there's one thing here we're going to be focusing on, and that is power creep. Now, power creep, otherwise known as power creep, is when new content in a game will basically take the power away from the old content. And in my opinion, that is one of the worst things about Mayhem 2.0. And we're going to be talking about all the worst things about Mayhem 2.0. But before we start a video like this, I want to say this is not meant to be negative in any way at all. And in fact, I have a confession to you guys. I love Mayhem 2.0. In my opinion, Mayhem 2.0 is exactly what I feel like was promised to us when this game came out. And let me show you guys what I mean. So here is one of my oldest YouTube videos when this game first came out. And look, we are on Mayhem mode level 3. This was the original hardest Mayhem mode in the game. We have 100% health, 150% shield, and 150% armor. We have a bunch of random stat boosts or nerfs, like 50% less cryo damage, 50% less corrosive damage. And that's what Mayhem used to be. And for all you guys who played the game at that point in time with me, you guys remember going onto Reddit and complaining that Mayhem mode didn't give everybody big heads and stuff like that. And you know what? Gearbox listened to us and they gave us big head mode. And actually, I think big head mode is one of the new best modifiers you can get with Mayhem. So I think it's a very positive change. So when I say we're going to be talking about all the bad things about Mayhem, it's just constructive criticism, just so you guys know. And it's also just my opinion. You guys can feel free to have different opinions, but I've seen a lot of feedback from the community, and a lot of people feel like the game is unbalanced, and so do I. So I want to talk about it. Now, one of the major fixes I see is going to be fixing this power creep. So let me tell you guys exactly what I mean with the power creep with Mayhem mode and with the new weapons. So like I said, I just read to you guys the old Mayhem 3 modifiers. Let's take a look at some Mayhem 4 modifiers. And I'm using a Jolts Dude video because he's awesome. So Mayhem 4, we had 850% health, 1000 shields, and 1000% armor. And we had very minimal modifiers that didn't really affect our gameplay that much. And a lot of people liked this change versus the old Mayhem, but we knew Mayhem Mode 2.0 was coming. Keep in mind of this 1000% armor and shields, because let's talk about what Mayhem 10 is. Mayhem 10 has 12,500% health, armor, and shields to enemies. And that is, comparing to 1000, that is 12.5 times tankier enemies than what we used to play. Now, let's talk about the gun scaling. If you have a Mayhem 0 weapon compared to a Mayhem 10 weapon, a Mayhem 10 weapon is only about 2.5 times stronger than a Mayhem 0 weapon. So we are getting 12.5 times enemy health bonus, but our guns only do 2.5 times more damage. So this is very uneven scaling, and this is pretty much one example of the power creep in the Mayhem 2.0 system itself. Now, keep in mind, this isn't always a bad thing. Uneven scaling is okay. That's what creates difficulty, but this is just a little too much in my opinion. Now, let's talk about some of the brand new Mayhem 2.0 weapons. If we take a look here, we have a Chaosin and we have a Kibbsworth. We're gonna compare some other weapons as well, but just bear with me for a second. So the Chaosin and the Kibbsworth are completely different guns. However, if you're playing a Splash Mohs and you're looking for that perfect Splash SMG, 2 weeks ago it used to be the Kibbsworth, but now it's the Chaosin. And why is that? The Chaosin deals 4,700 damage, while the Kibbsworth deals about 4,800, which is 2,400 times 2. So they seem pretty even, right? Well, the Chaosin also leaves a sticky that deals another 4,700 damage. So this is literally double damage over the Kibbsworth. These are like the same kind of guns that fill the same roles in most builds. There's no reason to play a Kibbsworth when you can have a Chaosin. On top of that, you can easily farm this from Captain Trunt. How many times can you kill Captain Trunt in 1 hour versus completing the entire Malawan takedown in 1 hour? Let's show the Monarch and the Dictator. These are very similar weapons, but the Monarch has almost double the base damage and one extra pellet. The Monarch does 3,300 times 4. The Dictator only does 1,500 times 3. And then we have the Brainstormer and the Reflux. This is basically the same gun, except the Reflux is corrosive. And if we look, the Reflux does 2,200 times 7, and the Brainstormer does 1,300 times 7. So if we go back to that definition earlier I kind of gave, power creep is when the new content in the game takes away the power from the old content. And pretty much it seems to me like that's exactly what happened with the Mayhem scaling, and that's exactly what happened with the brand new weapons. So in my opinion, one fix to this is to nerf the Mayhem scaling itself and nerf the brand new weapons. Now, what this will do is if we bring them down the same amount to the old weapons level, then the new weapons will not feel weaker because we bring Mayhem scaling down with it, and the old weapons will just feel better. Now, before we talk about why that might not be the right solution, let me compare it to something else very similar and something near and dear to me. Let's talk about the See Undead class mod for Zane. Now, for those of you who don't play Zane, See Undead is a class mod from the first DLC, and it is Zane's best class mod. You should never play another class mod. In almost all circumstances, you will be perfectly fine with the See Undead class mod. And the reason why is because all of Zane's other class mods are just not good enough compared to the See Undead class mod. And you know what? Things are fine. Zane does feel really good with See Undead. I am happy about it. But at the same time, I feel like I have to play with it because he's very hard in Mayhem 10 without that class mod on. You know what I mean? And one easy fix to this, in my opinion, is take the 25% from See Undead and put it onto See Undead. That nerfs the class mod, but it keeps the overall power level in the Zane build, because most people who play See Undead are spending enough points to get CN Red. So overall, the build does not change at all, but the viability of old options do, because now I can wear a different class mod and I get that 25% effectiveness. So that's kind of what I think needs to happen to Mayhem 10 and the Mayhem 10 weapons. If you bring them down together, then you keep that balance for how they feel in the game, but you make more other options viable. Now, another thing is, I get this is Mayhem 10. Everything shouldn't be viable. You should have to try to make your build. Well, the thing is, it's just like, Mayhem 10 isn't hard if I pick up a yellow cake or one of the new weapons. Mayhem 10 isn't hard. There is no challenge. And if I try to use old weapons in Mayhem 10, it almost feels like they don't work. One other issue with power creep, and a huge example of it, is if you look at the anointments you can get on your weapons. The most popular new anointment is 300% damage on enemies above 90% health. This is a 300% damage bonus. And that anointment makes the ridiculous scaling on Mayhem 10 way easier. You can get that anointment on some old weapons and they work in Mayhem 10. However, when I'm looting and all I find is sliding accuracy and handling or jumping crit, like if I jump, I get 25% crit damage, versus I can just have 300% damage just for shooting an enemy, pretty much. Like, it's all benefit on one side versus if I'm sliding, I get accuracy and handling. These anointments, like non-damage anointments, should not drop in probably Mayhem 6 and above. You can make an argument that Mayhem 8 and above is like, you know, that's where the cutoff should be. But my point is, like, damage anointments should drop. Now, I am really thankful Gearbox did make it so that in Mayhem 10, anointments are guaranteed on weapons, but we kind of just need that next step, in my opinion. One other thing I want to talk about, and one thing that I actually seriously think needs addressed, is the community itself, us. Me, I am fully guilty of this as a YouTube content creator. Gearbox released Mayhem 2.0. They released levels Mayhem 1 through 10. Now, I'm not saying you have to play each level, because that's just not true, but all of us hopped directly into Mayhem 10. One of my first videos were how to get a Mayhem 10 Sandhawk. That was right when Mayhem 2.0 came out. If you go into trading discords, you see people requesting very specific Mayhem 10 weapons with perfect anointments and god rolled class mods and the whole nine. Now, obviously, people want the most powerful items. You know what I mean? That is completely understandable. There's nothing wrong with that. But at the same time, we hop into the hardest difficulty in the game, and then we complain about imbalance. Now, obviously, there is some imbalancing, and there does need to be some balance in harder difficulty. Ultimately, my reasoning for coming to this sort of solution is because we kind of all agree that there is a bit of an imbalance right now, and instead of just buffing and buffing and buffing, when power creep happens, I feel like we need to bring the top of the ceiling down a little bit to match the rest of the group. One of the only other options to address this power creep, if they decided to, would be to buff weapons, right? Well, the thing is, there is so many weapons in this game that if we just buff a dozen of them, two dozen of them, three dozen of them, there's still a billion other guns that just won't be viable. Of course, like I said, this is an Everything Wrong with Mayhem 2 video. So we gotta mention all of the performance issues and the bugs, but hopefully Gearbox will be fixing all of this in the upcoming patches. That's actually one reason I think they released Mayhem 2.0 before they released the Guardian Takedown, and I give them major respect for that. I definitely appreciate them releasing Mayhem 2.0 beforehand, so that way we can iron this stuff out and we can have an awesome Guardian Takedown super soon. And that's one thing I love watching, is I love watching this game grow and get better and better. Like, when Borderlands 4 comes out, I hope Slayer is just a part of the game already, because Slayer is one of my new favorite Mayhem modifiers. Like I said, Big Head mode is freaking awesome, but obviously that shouldn't be a part of the game. So let's mention all the bugs that I can't even remember offhand. Chestnut scaling, Ista doesn't scale, Agonizer, Wotan's legs, vending machines, mail rewards, quest rewards. There's a bunch of stuff like that. Zane's digiclone, Moses' iron bear, Flax pets, even Amara's phase slam. Like, Amara's super powerful right now, but there's no reason to use phase slam and phase cast because, I don't know, do they do anything to enemies? They just fixed Fracture with Phase Slam anointments. Shouldn't it be super fun to shoot your action skill at enemies and blow them up and then activate your Phase Slam anointment and then start shooting enemies then? You know what I mean? So hopefully they address action skills. They could easily just put action skill damage onto class mods as like a stat roll, or just like an anointment that's like 500% action skill damage. That's what it feels like it needs sometimes, 500%. But yeah, so I hope to see balance fixes. I would love to just see like stuff be viable. Slayer and stuff, it feels like melee's viable in a weird way, but I'm kind of cool with it. One other thing is, remember to report your bugs and any issues to 2K Games. I will be leaving a link in the description and the pinned comment for exactly where to report bugs in this game. Make sure you report it to 2K. The more bugs we report, the better the game is in the long run, and I am here playing this game for the long run, so I just wanna see it improve. Now, we are actually ending the Borderlands content. Today's video is kind of sponsored by BenQ. They sent me a monitor and they just want me to review it for you guys, and I am very happy to do so. So this is a huge 27-inch gigantic monitor with built-in 2.1 speakers and HDR, FreeSync, and 144Hz for the utmost smooth images. There's multiple ports for all kinds of content, and they have proprietary eye care technology for viewing comfort. Now, that is a line of specs they want you to know, but I'm telling you, this is one awesome monitor. I'm kind of used to the cheapest monitor on Amazon that can get the job done, and it's kind of one of those things for me where I didn't really know what I was missing out on until they sent me the better one. Now, this is gonna sound dumb, but one of my favorite things is actually the remote it comes with and the settings you can change. You can kind of change the audio qualities depending on what you're listening to. There's like dialogue versus actually listening to music and stuff, and the speakers are actually pretty great. You can also turn on the HDRI technology, which is a high dynamic range technique to reproduce a greater dynamic range of luminosity than what's actually possible with standard digital imaging. And what can I say? This is probably the best monitor I've ever gamed or watched movies on with my computer. One last thing I do have to say is don't let the size of it intimidate you. It's kind of like a mini television at first, but once you get used to it, it allows you to just do much more. Just having a larger screen in general allows you to just multitask much better. Anyways, if you guys want more info on this monitor, of course there will be a link in the description for you, so be sure to check that out. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, don't forget to drop a like on it and subscribe to the channel for more content just like this. Let me know what you guys think about Mayhem 2.0 in the comment section down below. Tell me the thing that has gotten on your nerves the most with Mayhem 2.0. And remember, don't worry about being negative. This is just constructive criticism. So anyways, guys, like I said, that is going to be it from me. I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out.